Yes, sir. You can start, sir. No problem.
Okay, fine.
Okay, sir.
You can see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Okay. So, as you know, the company name is Multicase, and the software which you, on which you are working is Case Ultra software.
Okay, sir.
And this Case Ultra software is developed as a research collaboration with US FDA. That is more than 15 plus years, and still it is going on. Right.
Okay,
so for the, doing the assessment, the two methods are required. One is statistical and another is knowledge-based. We also call it rule-based method, right? So these are the two methods which are required. And on top of that, we also shared one additional technology with you that is used for your expert review, and we call it Consolidator. I believe you have seen that. I will show you in the demo part also. So,
okay.
Yeah. So, as far as this ICHM 7 guidance is concerned, this is for the assessment and control of DNA reactive impurities, mutagenic impurities in pharmaceuticals to limit the potential of carcinogenic risk, right? So, where does it applies? It applies to the impurities for the new drugs, which are in the clinical trials, and it applied to the impurities which are already available APIs, generic drugs. So whatever the impurity you are getting, you can there also it applies, and it can also be used in excipients that are used for the first time and are chemically synthesized. And where it does not apply, like drug substances and product intended for advanced cancer indications, and drug substances that are itself toxic. Right. And it is also not intended for biological, biotechnological peptide, oligonucleotides, radiopharmaceuticals, herbals, crude products, animal products, and to the flavoring and coloring agents, and to the leachable. But nowadays it is using in leachables. Right. So if required, they can ask you to write a report of toxicity assessment on ICHMs if you are working on the leachable compounds. So the software contains two different models. The first model is called a statistical model, which contains a training size of approximately 11,479 compounds, right? And all these the training details, what we have, the data we have, they are tested against all five important bacterial strains that is required whenever you are submitting any evidence to regulatory agencies. It may be FDA or it may be any other agencies throughout the world, and properly validated using OECD guidelines principles. So whenever we share the details with you, we always share the OECD models also. And whenever you submit the report, it is required to attach this OECD models also with your report. And very proudly, we say that we have a very good chemical coverage, because the data which we are talking about, it is biggest in market. None of the software have that much data coverage. So first, that is your statistical model. We have one more statistical model that is called PharmBut. And the training size of this model is again 17,691 compounds. Again, it contains all the relevant bacterial strains tested negative along with this OECD principles. What is the difference between this statistical model and first one? The PharmBut model is a proprietary data set actually. So we have received this model from lots of pharma companies, lots of research organizations like FDA and other regulatory agencies, and some universities also who are contributing to the database. So because they are proprietary, so you cannot see the structure in most of the cases we have shared. And whenever you when you are like to use this statistical model only when you face any issues with GT1 underscore BMUT and GT underscore expert model, that is rule based. Then you can try this third model. Otherwise, you can go with the first two model, that is more than enough. So the second model which we are talking about, means in this case it is the last model, the rule based model, that is we call GT expert. It contains approximately 200 alerts, and these alerts will actually help you to make the final judgment, right? And again, it is taking care of all those bacteriologist and everything. So the scientific background which is required to submit the analysis and all relevant aims details, experimental details, you will receive from the software when you apply the consolidator. Along with this database, we also contain some database on mutagenicity database molecule basically. So we contain some rodent carcinogenicity, about 2000 compounds. So if your query molecule have any literature regarding the carcinogenicity, that will be highlighted, right? So it will give you the details of the bacterial stains, assay condition, metabolic activations, and other relevant informations along with the other bibliographic informations or literatures, whatever required. So this is the basic workflow of the software, how you have to work on the software. The first primary part is preparing the input. Once you're done with the input, then you select the model, that is your statistical model GT1 underscore BMUT and GT underscore expert. You can see I have not highlighted FarmBut here because the primary model which are required to be used is these two only. And then once you're done with the selection of the model, you will get some output. So sometimes if you are getting a negative prediction from both of the model, that is well and fine. But again, if you face any out of domain or inconclusive or difference in opinion of the two model, one model says it is negative, another says it is positive, then what is the final call? How you will conclude this? So this is the unique feature which is not available with any other software. Here in our KSALTA software, you will get a feature called consolidator, and it will give you the final judgment that this call is positive or negative. And why it is positive or negative, it will highlight all the relevant documents required. Like if you have any experimental literature about the AIIMS report, it will give you. Or if it will take you to the nearest analogs, and basis of that, it will conclude that your compound is negative. Again, if you are looking your query in contrast to the API, in most of the cases, you are looking on the impurities with respect to some API. So it is always suggested to tell consolidator that my API is sitting on that ID. So if you tell properly, the judgment may differ, and you will get more concrete idea about your impurities and all. So these are the three parts: preparation of input file, then selecting the model, and consolidator is done by software. Now the last one more, the two part. You will get the report of the entire data by our using the report wizard, but you have to write some expert review on that, and that is not done by software. That is a manual job actually. So whenever it is also not advice to just share whatever you are finding getting from the software to the regulatory agencies, because they are having a lots of query they are receiving from lots of organizations. So what they need a summary. Whatever the finding you have to draft a proper summary and then submit to it in form of this expert review report. So we have some template for that. I can share with you. I have always shared with your previous colleague, Dr. Subhas also. And he have produced some fantastic report using our reference. So if you don't have, I can say it once again with you. I believe you have the case that sample report with you, Dr. Samesh?
No, sir. You can send me, sir.
Okay, I can send you once again. Thank you. Yeah. So now just move to the software part. So, right.
Hello, Yatin, just ask them if they have any questions till now.
Yeah, if you have any questions, please let me know. We have not started with the software part. So before going to the software, if you want to ask any query or anything about...
Yeah, you know, you are saying two models now, sir.
Right.
In a statical model and a base rule model.
Right.
You know, some cases we are getting in a negative one case, another one is positive.
Right.
So we are confusing about that, what result we need to take.
Right, right. So
at this time, we can consider a consolidator result.
Result. Yeah, so that doubt actually I will clear it today. So that is the beauty of the software also. So when you open the software, you can see something like this. Yeah, my desktop is clear, visible to you, all of you?
Yes, sir. Visible, sir.
Okay, great. So this green window, you can see, this is the basically a model, right?
Okay.
You can select the model from here. In your case, you have only one model for mutagenicity, genotoxicity, ICSM-7. If somebody is doing some on skin and eye and they have purchased that model additionally, they can add this model from this change folder icon. And if you go downside, you can see in your case, you have this this model only. But if you are interested, I mean, if you have taken other models like skin and eye, all other models you can get from the software. Right? This genotoxicity, cardio, carcinogenicity. But in your case, you have only these two models. Expert and BMUT. And last one, FarmBUT. Fine. Okay. So the this is your model interface. Then whenever you run any job, it is always selected. You select this test chemical from data curator. You can go by this one also, but it is not recommended. Whenever you are having some bunch of chemical, always suggested select this data curator. So when you select data curator, you can see data curator is highlighted here. And in load chemical option, you will get all input way, how you can give input to your data. Right. So basically, you can load in SD file, mole file, or you can copy and paste, or you can draw a structure.
Okay.
You are familiar with the SD file? What is SD file?
No, sir. You are just doing a copy, paste from clipboard.
Okay. SD file is .sdf file actually. So this is another way of saving a chemical structure in that file. For suppose you are having some molecule, I will just show you what this HD file means. One second. This is one more way of preparing a data set.
Okay.
Yeah. But it is always recommended go by this Excel sheet option. That is best way. Or Notepad. This is
not from Notepad. We are copying from Excel, sir.
Ah, perfectly okay. I will show you both of the options. So,
okay.
Suppose I have, I have some molecule. I have, for example, I have benzene here. Now I can save this molecule in, if you see, .sdf, right? If I make this .sdf, it will save in my benzene into .sdf file format. Or if you are familiar with the ChemDraw, in ChemDraw you can see .mol file. Right? These are the different way of saving the file. Like SMILE, INCHI. This is one way of saving the file. So you can prepare data input in .sdf or .mol. Okay. I will show you more easier way actually. Fine. So let's take the example of this Excel sheet first. So these are the standard way of preparing the means file. So I have prepared one Excel file, and you need to copy from row 1 to column C, then down to row 7, control C. How to prepare this file, I will show you. Then load chemical, paste from clipboard. So you can see there are 7 chemicals in data curator, and they do not contain any error or duplicates. So if you face any error or any duplicates or any salt-like structures, it will be highlighted in error message, right? And okay, this is one way. I will just empty it. Another way, if you don't have the structure, but you know the structure in some literature and you want to draw the structure, so definitely you can draw it like that. If you want to draw, you can draw the structure. After drawing, you have to tune the chemistry of the molecule. So you can see one refined structure icon is there. It will take care of the bond angle, bond distance. It will collect the geometry. So by default, few of the elements we have highlighted. But if you are interested to take another element from the periodic table, click on all, you will get access to the entire periodic table, right? So you can select whatever the element you want to select, then you can add in your drawing. And also if you want to generate the SMILE code for your structure, you can do that. Just click on copy. Even when you click on the copy as a SMILE will be generated, and you can paste it on your Excel sheet. So if you want to create a SMILE code for your structure, you can do that. See, software need actually only input. You have to give structure or these files, MOL file, SD file, right? So whenever we are opening this, what do you call Excel sheet, so what software need? Software will do its job by just this SMILE code. When you supply the SMILE code, it will generate the structure. But what problem you will face? You will not able to recognize your molecule, that this particular chemical represent which what is the name of this molecule. So it is suggested write the name. So it will help you to distinguish the name of the molecule. When you are running a bunch of molecule, 10, 15, then it will help you to trace the molecule with the name. Okay. So I will now show you how to create this kind of file. I will just take one new blank Excel sheet. Okay. And I will copy data from different file. For example, okay, suppose I have this case ID. Yeah. Just paste it, nothing else. Or you want to, if highlight that in first you are putting this case, so just you can tell cast number, and next one is with my SMILE. And this will be my name. Fine. Okay. Yeah. Then copy your name. Properly, you have to copy. Control C. Then click on this next box. The main problem, I believe, when you shared that file, that you are facing an error, the program is and getting shut down with some error. That is happening because of the new line character. So,
yes, sir.
So you should to take care of that. There should not be any new line. So if you just click next on your keyboard like this and Control V, you have entered the SMILE code, then now you copy the name of the molecule. So this is my impurity. Control C. And see, from here, how to move to the next column now? Just take the next button of your keyboard. Next, Control V. Properly it is generated. Similarly, you can go for this. So if I copy this one, Control C. And paste in the software. See, it is added. Right?
Right, sir.
Yeah. There is one more option, actually. I will just show you that also. You can prepare in this way also. This one. This we call text file, actually. If you want to prepare in this way, you can do it. How you can do? This is tab separated. new. You can copy from anywhere literature. I am just copying from the Excel sheet. If you are having some literature, PDF file, some Word file, or you are typing manually, entering, you can do it. So how to create this file? Just this one. Keep your cursor here. Next, your input, Control C. Then, now just click a tab button in your keyboard. One tab and Control V. That's it. Then name. Copy the name, Control C, then again one tab and Control V. First line done, next line. Copy this number, Control V. Copy this tab. Control V and your last name. Control C. One tab, press one tab button, Control V. Done. Now I am just pasting from here. See, I just copied it. Control C. Now I will open the software. I will remove everything. Empty data creator. Paste whatever I copied from the text file. You can see everything is here. Without any error, right? This is clear to you?
Yes, sir. Clear, sir.
Okay, perfect. So you can see a different way of preparing the file. You can prepare this text file. You can prepare this Excel file.
Next day we are prepared Excel same way, sir.
Okay.
So this we are not getting any problem.
Yeah, perfectly okay. Now, one more thing I want to tell you. Suppose you have only cast number.
Okay.
And you don't have the structure for that. So, here software will help you with one additional feature actually. You just paste. So, what I have done, I have pasted the cast number. But you can see there, we are not getting any structure. Right? So, we have two options here. Either I can get the structure from web. If I click, it will generate. See, I got the structure from web for first molecule. But for second, third, it is not there. So we can do it one by one by clicking on this get structure from web or in one click. One step cure. Select this. Download structure from PubChem. And it is always suggested that you should neutralize the charges, positive and negative charges, because it will end up with out of domain situation. So when you neutralize the charges, it will take care of that. Then click on proceed. So it will take some time. You will see something will happen here.
Yes.
So now software is getting database from the sites where it is available, PubChem or all. So now we have a structure for all molecules, right? So what you can see, the name is not there. If you want to enter the name, you can enter it.
There is a manual entry in name.
Yeah. You have to manually enter it. See, Isita, Might, for example. So you can add it, right? If you click OK, you can see the name is added here. Similarly for all, correct? So like that, you can add the name, you can create everything what you want to do. Okay. So now we are just going to our standard file and I will show you the basic workout of the software. Control C. Load chemical from clipboard. Yeah. So in my case, there is no error. So it is loaded. Fine. Now you select the model first. This model and second model, not third model. Only first two models are required. This is only in case of any issues if you are getting from the two model. Now just click on run test.
Actually, during we are taking three models, sir. We are taking three models.
No. Don't take three models. I have seen in your report. third model, sir, third model is a gifted free of cost to you, and that is not required to be used always, right?
Okay.
This is model when you face any problem with above two model. See, when you got some out of domain like situation,
right.
Then you want to check. Then in that case, it will use you. But most of the times, these two models are enough. I will show you some details. See, this model, if you right click, display training set, I will show you. What kind of training set it contains? 17,691 entire data you will see.
Regularly, we are doing with the three models.
No. You do with the two model. Selecting third model is not wrong actually, but it is not required. If you are getting some problem, then you use it.
What type of problem, sir?
Out of domain. You feel that you are getting, you know, this molecule have some is not coming proper judgment. You are getting out of domain or inconclusive. Then you can try this model. See, these are the chemicals. For this, we have the structures and they are the activities. But you will see in downside. Yeah, these are the property chemical. You cannot see the structure, right? But knowledge has been extracted. And with that knowledge, you can actually do the prediction of your molecule. So you can use all this model only when you face issues with above two model. Like out of domain, you are not happy with the judgment, and you want to see what this model did. This model give you some additional information? Then you try that.
Okay, right. This model is only for additional information and predictions only.
Pardon?
This model is based on only just predictions and
sir, predictions only. No? It will be same job what above two model is doing. This is a statistical model. But the data type, see, entire model is working on data only. So the data which we contain in this model, it is contributed by pharma companies and research organizations. So these are their property chemical. They don't want to share the structure. They don't want to open the structure. But they agreed to share the environment and chemical details. So we have used that information and prepare our training set. So this will give you advantage of additional coverage when you fail any issues with above two model. So it is not required to use these models. You always go with the above two model only, right?
Right, sir.
Okay, fine. Okay, so this is the finding which we have received, which we got by selecting these two models, fine. Now you see in GT1 it is positive, and GT expert it is positive. Here it is negative, but here you can see non-negative. What do you mean by non-negative? What software do when you do the run the job? First it look into the literature. Do we have any already known literature which have the experimental proof that this particular chemical is non-negative? Already tested in Ames test, and we know that if something known, the job of software is not required here actually. Software is just giving you the information that this information is available in literature, and if you click here, it will take you the relevant literature also. Right?
All right, sir.
So you have the experimental data for this molecule. Yeah. So when you run the, these are the conditions and strains about details of the strain. Back to the chart. Okay. And when something is negative and positive, here prediction has been done by using the software algorithm and knowledge. In my case, I have 6 impurities A, B, C, D, E, F, and 1 API. This is my API. Acetogelamide is my API. Right. So when you apply consolidator, it will prompt something like this. You specify inert substance or API. If you have API here, you tell my API is in ID number 7, right? So when you tell that your API is sitting on row number 7, the final judgment will be taken care of all impurities which are shared with API and give you some outcome with some clear judgment. Suppose we don't tell that about API. Let's see what happened. I'm not telling anything about API. Just run it. See, nothing new. We are getting the same kind of result. We have not shared any detail about API. So we are getting a positive, negative, and all. Now, this time I am telling that this 7 number is my API and your API is negative compound experiment. See, here it is written, it is experimentally tested negative. It should be negative. Then only you can tell about the API, right? So this time I am telling that my API is sitting on this ID 7 now. Okay. Now see what happened. So it is taking care, doing the judgment analysis, so looking on the environment of your impurities. See, previously it is coming positive, right? Now it become negative. Why? Any idea, sir? Why it become negative? Hello, Dr. Ramesh?
Yeah, no, sir.
So, yeah, why it is getting negative? It should come positive because here it is positive, but it become negative. So, this is the power of the consolidator. Normally, what happens when we do the synthesis, these impurities, most of the times, they are shared with our API. And we know our API is experimentally tested negative, right? So, right. If something is shared with API, that is also comes under the negative part. So, here this API, individually it is positive. But yes. when you considered with respect to API, it become negative. I will show you. If you click here. Sorry. See, this is your query chemical.
Okay.
If you go downside, it will give you negative. Why it is negative? A potential ICHM7 class 4 compound. It is also telling about the class. So most of the times the class 4 compounds are shared with API. But this you should not rely blindly on the judgment. See this, they have what they have written. Expert review tips. It is not guaranteed. And here you can see keyword moderate. So there is a situation that this negative may become positive. So what you have to do, and software is also telling, you have to review the comparison with inner substance and API. And then finally conclude your judgment that this is negative or positive. So let's move one by one. This is our first method. Statistical. It is telling positive. Why? Because 3 positive alerts, right? Again, this is rule based. It is giving 1 alert. Total how many alerts? 4 alerts. 3 from statistical, 1 from rule based. Now we have to qualify each alert one by one. And this is the beauty. When you prepare the expert review report, you have to highlight these key parts. So this is my query chemical, and these are the analogs. And you see my analog is 0.75% similar to, 75% similar to my query chemical, and it is negative, right? And all nearest analog, if you go through, what you have to see? You have to see the similarity and environment around the analog. Environment should be near about to this your query molecule. and in majority of the cases it become negative, right? Then again go downside. This is my API, which I tell that in ID number 7 is my API, and my query chemical. What differences it have the API? This yellow region. These are the difference with API. So, what really you have to justify? You have to justify this yellow region all that. This is out of API, and finally it is calculated as negative. How? Go one by one. Following alerts are shared with a inert substance. This one all. So total 4 alerts, and all are shared with API. So we will take one by one. First, this one, 39. See, alert 39. Now what happened? This alert is dismissed because it is shared with inert API, right? If you go downside, this is your this alert is present in the following supplied inert substance API, and if you see the nearest analog for this particular alert, you are getting 4 alerts which are negative, right? On majority call, it is concluded that finally it is negative. Similarly, it will take another alert 51.
This but alert, what about positive, sir?
Pardon?
What about that positive alert, sir?
See, this is if you see this alert, positive alert, and here the environment of this alert and the group containing this alert, it is not exactly very near to your query molecule. 0.107, and they are 0.703.5. So they are more similar to your query molecule, right?
However, we are getting negative. Some positive alert is there now, sir.
Yeah.
Can we consider or not? Why we are not considered?
Because of the majority call. The majority call is negative here, right?
Majority call only. Okay.
Majority call is negative, and you will also get another hints. If you see the majority call is negative, so okay. On basis of that, it is concluded and it is shared with API also. So this become negative, and you can see if something become negative, it is experimental data. It is not prediction, and this is the
positive idea. Positive is also experimental data.
Yes,
na?
Yes, it is experimental data, but the similar you have to look on this score similarity. Yeah. See, 0.107, 0.559, 0.703, very highly similar, and not only that, you have to look on the environment also. This environment. And look on the this environment, right? So means here you have to apply your chemistry knowledge also somewhat to justify the final things. Then it will take the another alert, so it will go one by one for each alert and give you the relevant details and all. See here, all analogs are negative.
Okay.
Then it will give you some mechanism also. You can include this in your report. Then if in my case, there is no detail about the carcinogenicity, so you are not getting any information. But if it is available for your chemical, it will be highlighted here with strains and other details. So these are the experimental report which are required actually. Bike ID, right? So you will get these details. Then further more details on experimental data, and finally the references. For each experimental report, they have some reference here like this, so you will get references here all, right? And in last again it will give you your two the outcome from the two model, because this consolidated give you the consolidated report of entire experiment. So this is your statistical report, positive, and downside this is your rule based report, right? So this is the report you are getting from the consolidator. Now you have to prepare the report wizard. So this is individual. So you can generate one by one for each model, and you can generate in Excel, in PDF, in Word, whatever. But the final report, which will help you to write the consolidated this expert review, you can get from this part. By clicking on Excel, you will get the outcome details. Like the, if I click here, generate, you can see.
Yeah.
Okay, it will give you something like this. These are my query chemical, right?
Yes.
And these are the final output from the consolidator. And these are the finding. But now we have to prepare a final draft. Okay. So you can generate the final report in PDF by clicking on this PDF report, and if you you can see this quick test 115. So quick test 115, name of the file in which this entire report will be go. If I click generate report, now it is generating a consolidated report for all 7 chemicals, including your API. So it will take some time. And the by default path is my desktop, so it will go to the desktop, right? So once so it will take some time to generate the final report. So once the report, yeah, it is about to done. So this is same report which I have shown you by clicking here.
Okay.
Direct clicking. So now you are getting in PDF file which you can attach with your expert review. So this is not very hardware intensive job. Any computer with Windows 10 operating system, genuine operating system with normal RAM and some space in their hard disk, they can use it.
Not.
Yeah. So it's not very hardware intensive job required. So any specific high-end computer systems are required for doing the calculations. So it will take some time. In between, I will just switch you towards the expert review. This is the actually expert review which really you have to share with the regulatory agencies, right? So you have to tell that what report you have prepared. You can actually, this is prepared by our domain expert, Dr. Suman Chakraborty. So he has written his name. You can write your name here and dates and everything, which software you have used, what are the methodology you have used, rule-based and statistical, right? Then summary. In summary, we will tell that I have started with my API that contains so-and-so impurities, and I concluded that these impurities fall in class 5 and 4, right? So once you're done, then you have to give the evidence that this is my API. API is non-negative. You can highlight the literature from where you are telling it is non-negative. You can highlight the experimental details that is attached downside in report in experimental data. Then you take one by one your impurity. Your impurity number one, it is negative by both of the methods. Then finally, why it is negative, we have to make the judgment. All relevant literatures, what you're finding, you get from the software. And if you have something in-house available, from your own finding, and you know that this is negative because of that reason also, you can include that also in your finding. So it is telling about each and every impurity like that. Then you take the analogs also, which you got from the software. For each impurity, they are highlighting the analogs. Then this mechanism background, all these details you will get from this consolidator, which we are downloading right now. Then these are the analogs highlighted, which we have shown in the software for each impurity one by one. This is the final experimental data now. This is my query chemical 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 9. This is the bacterial stains in without S9, with S9. These are the references. Then highlight the conditions, negative, positive, whatever finding you have. Then negative in OECD for strains are all details. Finally, these are references, highlight the references also. So like that, you have to prepare the expert review report. And this you have to submit to the agencies. And finally, attach the output of the consolidator, the rough file which you have received from the software. I believe it is generated. Then this QMRF document. Already we shared with you. If you want again, we can mail you. So that you have, that you can include in your final adjustment. So I believe my job has been done. Okay, report is generated. 115, quick test 115. Okay. Quick test 115. This is my report. See, I got report for all 7 chemical. You click, you will get brief details what I tried to show in the software itself. Like that. All. Right. API, then the alerts, then discussing each alert one by one, cancelling and justifying your call. Right. Everything. So you got information for all of your chemical entries, and then you can prepare this finally. So this is something which is done by you, not by software, and you have to do this manually. And already whatever I am showing you, we have cross-checked with the US FDA, and they agreed that if someone follow this way of drafting their report,
can you send this draft report, sir?
Pardon?
Can you send this draft
report? I will mail you, sir. I will mail you. I will mail you this report, and you can take it as a reference.
Just and the MRF also.
MRF also. You can take this as a reference and try to prepare your own report. Again, okay. If you come up with any issues while preparing the report, want to discuss something on that, we are open for that.
Okay, thank you.
Right. So this is all what I plan to demonstrate today. And I'm recorded this session. If you need the recording, I can share the link with you.
Okay. Thank you very much, sir.
So any queries you have?
Sir, yes, sir. What is the criteria for you are previously were saying majority portion in out of five conclusions we are getting one positive and another three are negatives.
You're telling about this one, right?
Yes.
So these are the alerts actually which is highlighted by the software, and these on the basis of these alerts actually the you are getting a positive. These alerts says that this is positive, this is positive. And now what your job is, your job, you have to qualify this alert one by one. You have to tell that no, this is not positive, because this is shared with API. And if you look into the nearest analog, which are similar to the environment of the query chemical, they are also negative. So finally, we conclude this is not positive, this is negative, right? Mm. It may happen that sometimes you see if here it is written moderate, and you
that is my main doubt. In two models in GT expert or GT BM2, result is outcome is the positive, but finally it is comes negative. How it is come? That is my doubt. But okay, it's fine.
I think you got the answer why it become negative.
Yes, fine.
Because of the. By looking into the relevant analogs and all literature details, we finally conclude. So you are not telling blindly. You are telling on the basis of proof, concrete proof you are giving. This is 8956 and it is negative. So you are giving a concrete proof. I will show you. 8956. Negative. Right?
Yeah.
So you are giving a detail. 8956. Negative. Speech, test conditions, all relevant information you are giving. You are not telling just by any guess. We are putting our conclusion on the basis of some detailed report with some experimental evidence, and that is really you need to highlight in this report. See, we have included all this experimental data here. See,
yes.
So actually, the what is our job? We should prepare our report in such a way that whenever any scientist from FDA or any regulatory agencies look into the report, they will just looking on the report, they get the answer. Yeah, they are telling this is negative, and this is the final drafting on the basis of that, they are telling negative. If you share this report directly to them, this one, they will confuse because they don't have enough time to see your report one by one, right?
Right.
So better you should draft something like this or anything which you know. This is only one way we have told you. You can prepare in Excel sheet, in whatever, but it is up to you how you want to means write. Just to give you some idea, we have plan. We have prepared this rough report so that you can take this as a reference, right?
Right.
Yeah.
Sir, so, one more doubt.
Yes, sir.
What is my doubt is, sir, impurity itself is positive, no, sir. But yeah, when compared to API, yeah, it is giving negative result.
Right.
What right. we are doing. So my doubt is, we haven't to control that impurity limits, no, sir.
No, not required actually. In this situation, it is not required. It is required because it is shared with API, sir. Something shared means it is a part of API. How it is prepared when you are doing the synthesis process, some impurities, they are actually coming from the API itself, right?
Yeah, yes, sir.
So,
over a period of time, mm-hmm, the impurity will generate, sir. Over a period of time, the main molecule will decompose or degrade, mm-hmm, and the impurity levels may increase.
Means that you have to take care that the concentration and all, that is, means already when you are doing the synthesis, you know about the concentration of your API, how much it is on the threshold level or not, or it is crossing the threshold, then obviously you have to control it. But as far as this ICHM's guideline is concerned, here when it is giving you the concrete idea that this is the thing, so as far as ICH output is concerned, you can blindly tell that this is negative. But if you see on the terms of the concentration and all, and you believe that it is crossing the threshold level, which is not supposed to be, then in that case, you have to work on that.
Okay.
Yeah. So actually, when you submit report, you are not submitting only this report. Apart from this, you are submitting some other report also. This is only for the ICHF7, right?
Yeah, yes, sir.
So in that control setup, you have to mention that. As per my knowledge goes.
Yeah, okay, sir.
Yeah.
One more, sir. 1 minute.
Yeah.
Sir, can we know the difference between the mutagenic and the genotoxic impurity? So whether it is positive.
I didn't get you, sir. Can you repeat? Hello? I'm audible to you? Hello? Kiran sir, you can hear me?
No, we can hear you.
This is, I think Ramesh sir has got some network issues, sir. I'm able to hear you.
Okay, perfect. So, see, the positive and negative prediction, what you are getting, that is on the basis of this, right now what we are saying is bacterial mutagenicity model only, right? So these are the prediction which is actually done by the software. And if it contain the relevant experimental data that is highlighted in the report of the consolidator.
They have gone out. What happened?